Globally, 26,000 terawatt hours of electricity is produced every year. Around 16% of that comes from hydro energy, or 4,200 terawatt hours, a number that has doubled in the last 25 years. In this video, we will cover the expansion in hydropower across the globe in the last decades and visualize it on a world map. We will start our time frame for this video in 1965, and every marker on the map indicates 10 kilowatt hours of hydroelectricity produced. By 1965, 16 nations are represented on this map, with over 10 kilowatt hours produced every year. Canada and the US leads the world, ahead of Japan, Russia, and several European states. But hydro energy is also produced in low and middle income nations, like China, India, and Brazil. A couple of years later, the global production passes 1,000 kilowatt hours, and by 1975, it is close to 1,500. 10 years later, we see nations like Argentina, Chile, Mexico, and Pakistan joining on the map, while production fluctuates a bit up and down yearly, but is generally on the rise in Europe and North America. By 1986, the global production passes 2,000 kilowatt hours. But then it would take another 20 years until 2006 before it passed 3,000. That increase has mainly taken place in nations like China and Brazil, while the yearly production has stabilized in the high-income parts of the world. In the following years, we see many new dams being built in China, and the production in the fast-growing nation has doubled in just the last 10 years. China now alone stands for close to 30% of the global production. Hydropower is a more traditional renewable energy source than the, in the last few years, faster growing sources like wind energy. It so far contributes by far the most to the global electricity production of the renewable sources. But at the same time, investments have slowed down in many nations, not the least as a result of steep investment costs and great local and regional environmental impacts when building new dams. Hydropower is also, of course, dependent on the use of large rivers and elevation, and is not suitable for all environments. It can act together with less reliable renewable sources like wind and solar due to its storing of potential energy, and reduce the need for batteries when transitioning away from fossil fuels. I hope you enjoyed this short introduction into one of the main renewable energy sources in the world, and I have more videos on the topic coming out in the future. If you're interested in those or other videos of mine, you can subscribe or click through to one of the videos suggested on the screen right now.